So there was this, there was these scenes in his room, and there was quite an interesting shot in the, I have a picture of that, I'll show it to you later, and quite an interesting shot in this film where you're looking, he's lying on his bed in his little bed sitting room, and he's looking out of his window, and in a house some distance away that he can see from his window, because his house is up a bit of a hill, so he's sort of looking down across the valley, you could say. And some little way away, there is a house, and the sun is catching the window, so it's reflecting back strongly from that one window. Now, to get this actually to happen in practicality is almost impossible. So, as one of our £5 contributor members was an art director, who was already working in the film industry as an assistant art director, I think, he constructed a little model house, and we made we took a window frame, a full-size window frame with curtains and window and two window panes and curtains and a frame, and we took this out onto a terrace, and we propped it up on with scaffolding, and put the camera behind. So the camera is looking, it's got in the foreground, you have this window frame, and some distance behind, some maybe 10 feet behind, you have a platform, and on the platform is this little model house, which is only that tall, but made in great detail, like a film model. And you could, and has a, it has a glass in one window, and you could turn it in such a way that you could make the sun reflect back into the camera. And this shot is in the film, and it's very successful. But of course, it's quite a lot of trouble to get. But it's all good experience. Anyway, so there's that scene in his little bedroom, and then he goes out, and then there's a scene under a railway viaduct just beyond London Bridge Station, where it was a picturesque location. We were very careful to choose interesting locations. So we have this location where there's a series of bridges, almost like tunnels, very overhanging bridges, and he's walking along there, and he encounters a prostitute, and again, it's an encounter which takes place entirely without dialogue. You see them from the distance, so they exchange some words, but you don't hear what they're saying, and basically, you say, "This is not for me," kind of thing. And he walks on, and she looks after him. He's quite a handsome boy, you know. So that's one little incident. And then there's a second sequence outside a dance hall at night, where, again, he's passing by, and he hears all the noise of the dancers coming out from this dance hall, and he sort of wonders whether to go in or not, and then a newspaper boy passes, a little child selling newspapers. And there's a headline on the paper, something about war, threatening war, or something like that. So he sort of says, "Oh, well, good." And he gives some money to the newspaper. He buys all the newspapers. And the boy runs away happy with his couple of shillings or something. And he doesn't use them to go in the dance hall. And then he walks on again. And then just before that, or just after, I can't remember the sequence exactly, but he... he makes a phone call because he wants to ask some friends whether they will go out with him. I think this comes before. And he goes to a phone box and he wants to make this phone call. And it's getting dark, so it must be before the night scene at the dance hall. And there's a girl in the phone box. And she's very romantically lit. She's got blonde, long blonde hair, you know. He's waiting to use the phone, but he's considerably taken with this image of this girl in the phone box. And eventually the girl finishes her conversation and sort of they exchange a look, and then she goes off and he makes his phone call. And he phones a couple, friends, one takes it. And you see the couple in their flat, and you see him answering the phone. And then he says something like, "No, I can't come out tonight. I've got Lizzie with me." And he puts his arm out, and the camera swings over, and you see there's a girl sitting next to him. From behind, you see all this, so there's no lip sync problems, you see. And he puts his arm around this girl. So it was all designed to be visual as much as possible. So he puts his arm around this girl and says, "I can't come out. I'm with Lizzie," whatever. So Brian puts the phone down, and. And he goes off, and then he goes to the dance hall and so on. And then he goes into a cafe, and who should be sitting in the cafe but the girl from the phone box? Ta-da!